Greetings, mortals. I am Natus, one of the rulers of Hell, or specifically Monger Hell, and today we will be reacting to the newest chapter of Welcome to Demon School, Iruma-kun, chapter 225, Starting Off with a Pop. Isn't that supposed to be a bang? Eh. Who cares about these little details? Let's just get into this chapter because God knows I'm gonna be overly analyzing a lot of chapters and small moments. Especially considering the fact these chapters are probably just going to appear in like one or two panels at the end of major school event arcs. But, oh well, let's get into it. So anyways, first we see a bunch of ruins. Well, I guess we have a time skip actually. And now we have the Woodbones be like, now is the age of chaos. This apocalyptic netherworld is a lawless place where criminals run wild. It's hell, dude. That happens all the time. Like, half the time I do that on purpose just so I'll watch a bunch of people torture themselves. Oh, but don't say that to my supervisors. They think it's some scheming, but not actually just me doing it on purpose. But yeah. Anyways, then we see this actually cool looking demon guy. Like with a cool scythe, cool helmet, pretty badass looking guy, and then kind of cool looking guy, but not, I can't really say much about him. I guess these are gonna be battle soldiers finally revealed, huh? It's about time, honestly. So yeah, now we have here a group of terrifying monsters known as the Teachers of Babylon, wreak havoc day after day. Well, they are teachers, so what'd you expect? Who would think that teachers would be the first to join battle? And then we have someone be like, and the narrator, by the way, and the teacher's favorite food is a demon's heart. How scary! That's a weird way to say it. And then we have the same guy being like, hand over your heart. And then we see a random civilian be like, eek! Help! Someone please! And then we have a swoosh as we see Iruma with a blade coming to defend the little girl. As Iruma's like, are you hurt? And then the little girl's like, I'm okay. Wait, you guys are... And then we see the demon guy be like, oh shit. And then we see Naresh be like, however, the netherworld still has a spray of hope. Indeed, some strong and noble demons still remain, shine, as we see Asmodeus and Cresselia approaching. Where, and they all seem to have this like weird, like this ribbon tie around their hands, as they have, as Nerys is like, they will defeat the monsters and protect demonkind, the demons of justice, the 13 misfits, as we see all of them doing their posing moments. Like, Iruma's with his hand up and his other hand on his waist. Valak, Clara is using the batons. Asmar is posing like in some cop movie. Sometimes behind being the macho man. Lee's like, yeah. And it's just like, ugh, why are we doing this? The lion guy is like just staying there like calming, yeah. Elizabeth is doing a sexy pose, Cresselia is like putting her glasses up, like in disgust, Gap is like going for a sword, the owl guy is like, whoo, as Arthur is just like, oh, you got so loud. So, yeah. Alright, I said, are they making a movie? I mean, I was just joking last chapter, but are they seriously making a movie right now? I mean, even the people's reaction to it is like, kind of a movie, where they're just all screaming like, yeah. And then we get to the exam. That's for some reason a movie. And now we have, now then, a huge crowd has gathered in the outer courtyard to watch the Misfits rank promotion exam. And then we see the news announcers, as we see the one who seems to be wearing the school uniform being like, what you say saw earlier has the promotional video for the exam. It's available on the school's website. And then we actually see the comment section on it as like one, so I was like, so cool. I can't wait. The music commenters like, the music faced winners are awesome. The Misfits are really into it. And then we see another one be like, this is a waste of the school's budget. I'm guessing that commenter is Caligo. By default. I mean, I was like, you know, who would be saying something like that outside of Caligo? Now we have the other news that's be like, now let's go over the rules once again. Once again? Seriously? I really would be mad to just say, let's get over the rules, but alright. So anyways, now we see a bit of a, you know, those dorky ways to explain the rules. So yeah, we have the title of the... Well, the name of the rules are like the Heartbreakers rules. I guess that's the name of the mission of what they'll be doing. So yeah, now we see a picture of like Simple Demons with two having balloons and one having the pop. As then we have the narrator be like, protect the heart-shaped balloon that is fastened to each of the first years. And then we see another like, I'm guess this is what the teachers are gonna be dressed like with some kind of like mask. As they're like, Misfits will be eliminated if the teachers pop both of their first year's balloons. Simple. And now we get to see Ameria. And then we have the narrator be like, so, President, what are your thoughts on the rules? As the Ameria's like, well, you must protect not only yourself, but also other demons. The bar is set high. As we see a bunch of the people on the stand be like, oh, the President, wow-wee! Oh, she is. To a very high-ranking girl in Iruma as well, so it makes sense. So then we have the other news announcer be like, so about this new type of exam, so exciting! And then we see one of, I'm not sure we, I'm guessing it's Smoke, I feel like that's Smoke. Smoke from Ameria Student Council, who's like, indeed, since... And she's like, since it's a joint event, this will also be a good opportunity for the second and third years to see what the new first years are capable of. I'm guessing for those tasks, for those like groups they make. And then we have another that news announcer to be like, by the way, are there any first years that catch your attention? And then we see Ameria taking a sip and she's like, let's see, I think the top scorer, Chrysalis Shima. And then we have Chima there, as Ameria's like, because, since, you know, she's her rival to get Iruma's love. And then we have the news to be like, so, are you planning to scout her for the student council? And Ameria's then like, well, and then we have Smoke be like, she might join our Batra if we don't act fast, just like Asmodeus from last year, right, Press? To be fair, as it only wanted Iruma, not Asmodeus, so it's not really gonna matter that much. And yeah. Then we see her fantasy where she sees Iruma standing and Shima is like on him. And then Ameria's like, join another Batra? And then it's like, Ichima's like, I entered Iruma's Batra. And Iruma's like, she entered my Batra. Because, which is what she basically much imagined what would happen. And then I was like, I will not allow it! And start screaming as the other two of them are like, what? And then we have Smoke like, oh my. And then we have Ameria's inner thoughts be like, that Gusali, there's no telling what you'll do if I take my eyes off her. Would it be best to keep her close by? Is there not thinking about that too? Wait. Kusari stop her, Ameria's picked up everything, make sure that she ends up with Iruma and not Kusari. And then we have the news to be like, looks like you really want her to join the student council. Yeah, that's not what's actually happening. And then we have that other guy be like, that's new. And then we have the news to be like, alright then, let's get this broadcast live. And then we remember from the second year's tower. And then we see Iruma and his two new members as the narrator's like, and there they are, the team that everyone has their eyes on, Team Iruma. Well, to be fair, it does make sense. It's, you know, top tier, the number one from the Misfit class, as well as number one from the 20, those best 26 first years. And then we see a tense holding between Cresselia, Irma, and that other guy. And then Amira starts to scream! And then starts thinking, well, what's this? Everyone's holding hands. And someone's like, why? And then there's like, looks like they got close, huh? And it was like, Shima-chan, why are we... And she was in like, Irma-senpai, there's a rule saying that we have to hold hands until the event starts. Then it was like, huh, oh, there is... As it was then like, is everyone else on hands? We have to follow the rules. And they're just like, they have great chemistry from the get-go. I'm not sure if they actually heard that discussion or what, but it's kind of... But still, hilarious. Especially Amira be like, I am too tall to even reach his hand. I guess that's what she's thinking, because what other guys like, press, are you okay? Which is true. And then we have Asmodeus' team. And then she'll be like, no, for Team Asmodeus. As, like, the other guy's still like, As they're like, yay. Which, again, say, I love how childish Sima is right now. And then we see the girls very much fangirling over Asmodeus and Zezu. As they're like, sound like, Asmodeus-sama, kya! Zezu-kun! And then we're there to be like, the girls are cheering for them like crazy. Which is true. I guess that's the reason why Zezu-kun and Asmodeus were put together, because the girls would go crazy. And then we're Zezu-kun being like, the cameras can't help but by follow my figure, so I'm outshining you, senpai. Wait, are you listening? As we see Asmodeus talking to Sylvia, as he's like, nice to meet you. He's like, I'll be in your care. Which is pretty hilarious. And then we see Team Balak. As then there's like, the other teams also seem ready to rock and roll. And then we see Clara actually using that thing that's supposed to be the headband around her neck, which I also think was before, but I just didn't notice it before. Okay, about that. As we see her and that one other girl who I think we saw a bit more of her in the last chapter, be like, yay! As we see the other guy from that was on Valak's team being like, what is going on? That was also a bit hilarious. Yes. Then we see Team Sabnock with him and having those two little ones where that fish guy who's like, yay! And the other guy's like, I'm dead. Like, she's not saying it, like, right now we just see their expressions, but I'm guessing that she's they're being to herself in the head. I'm fucking dead. Then we see Team Cresselia, where we see the other two, like, kind of, the other delinquents, like, looking at her, being like, ugh. And be like, As Cresselia's, like, looking at paper, I'm not sure if that's supposed to be an idol thing, or just a map of the school, or something. And I'm guessing these two aren't going to have as much of a good chemistry as the other four teams, or at least one of the members of the other four teams had good relationships. Then we see Team Alakor, the lion guy, as he's looking, I'm guessing, at the map. As he's like this and that, as the other two also look at him. Like a girl who seems to have like pigtails in a bun or something, and a bird-like student. Then we see Team Kamui. As we see the girl that had like one eye, having like a, you know, those, I guess, training swords for samurai. Samurai blocking Kamui from the other girl that was like, ugh, what? In the last chapter, which she saw that she was on Kamui's team, as that girl was also saying like, what are you doing? Which, I wonder if these two are like a master and a servant type of thing. Like this black-haired girl. It could be blue hair, but it's small, so I can't tell what color hair she's supposed to have. It's like comes from like a high-ranking family, while this other girl is like from a family that serves her or something. Because it's not just that she like is blocking him; it's also like she's blocking him as well as has like one hand stretched out, like keep away from her. Although there might be girlfriends. It's also that's possible. I mean, Cassandra is into girls, and in the last I think two arc, I mean, it, like in that idol arc, she has a girl. She pretty much is getting was already planning on getting engaged to someone. So I guess it could be that as well. I'm not exactly sure. Then we have Team Agares and similar to how Gap and Agares have like this kind of like. Guess like, yeah, let's do this. And guess like, no. It's like we're gonna have the similar thing with Agares and his two guys who follow him. Because one is like this kind of reminds me of a Kitsune with a flaming tail and those kind of ears. Since now we can see better of him. As the other guy with the one horn are like taking pictures. Is like, one's like, the guy with Kitsune is like this. And Agares is just like, ugh. So I'm a bit curious on how that's gonna be. And then we have Team Shanks, which is lead, and the other two. Is there like, as we say, step. So yeah. Now we cut to the actual dialogue. And now we have lead being like, I'm so nervous. Okay, first, maybe I should search for a place to hide, but the map exploration is first and four. As then he's like, then he hears Sparkles behind him. As he looks most, as he sees like the Cyclops and the other like kind of animalistic looking one, like all excited as they're like, looking like, he's like, we respect you so much. We never thought we would be on the same team as the Young King. And the Cyclops is like, we are so thrilled having the Young King makes our team as strong as 100 demons. So I guess this is referring to the event that's gonna be in the next season where there was a whole, you know, camp, you know, they're like in a forest trying to get stuff in that. Yeah, that's what they're referring to. As then Lee's like, whoa, you're, I'm guessing that's one of those two being like, whoa, you're even cooler in person. As Lee is surprised, shocked in how much they, those two respect him. And yeah, immediately Lee's like, leave it to me. Like, he was supposed to know, but he's like, oh yeah, I'm cool now. So yeah, then we have the other to be like, so cool, we expect nothing less of lead senpai, the Young King. And then the other one's like, this one eye one is like, what's the strat? Is that a certain way of saying strategy? And he's like, are we hiding? As he's like, no, let's assess the situation with level heads. We shouldn't be afraid to face the enemy directly. So cool. I guess he's getting a bit of an overconfidence boost here, lead. Your first strategy was pretty logical. As then he's like, relax, this is the way of the Young King. As they're like, so cool. Again, you're way overconfident, lead. I'm guessing he's gonna be the one to lose the first or something like that. So then we have the announcement to be like, looks like the old teams are ready. No, it's finally time to ring the starting bell. And then we get a picture of the teachers just with their masks, where I think we see the teacher that was teaching Balam and Caligo when they were students. Then I think we see the professor of plants. Then I think it's a guy that, the healing guy who got beaten up by Sabdog in the last year. And then I think we see Caligo's future wife, which supposedly enough, she seems like wear a different mask and also wears a hat. I'm not exactly sure. Maybe it was just like, all right, put whatever on just so you look, so you stand out. Like bad guys. Oh, they also wear capes, but that's not really important, anyways. As then we have as all eyes turn to them, full of hope and anticipation, let the heartbreaker. As then we see a bunch of people excited, as they are nervous because of Chima, and the bell is ranked. And then we have begin, as we see one of, lead students immediately, like the guy who is more animalistic, immediately having his bubble pop, As it reacts in shock, as we see a close up of the bubble, and then we have, oh, I found you, my student, as we see Robin, good teacher, surprisingly here. And then we have the chapter with Lead and the other two be like, Lead, I'm guessing screaming curse words as the other two are also in shock. I guess they weren't expecting, like, as soon as the bell rang to, like, for the teachers to attack. Like, maybe they were thinking they were going to be in a bit of a different location. Like, not really the first fucking second. Yeah. So, Robin is on this. I thought he was not going to be, because Kaluga said that they were going to be respectable individuals. Or that the teachers are respectable. So, I wasn't thinking Robin would be here. Although, I guess maybe it was like some kind of number thing where they were like, Kaluga, how do I say, like, I mean, I can imagine like this, that, like, the office was saying they had to discuss who's going to be where. And Kaluga was going to be like, alright, so, excluding Robin-san, I think we can work this out. Excluding Robin, we are doing all fine. And then, like, the teachers were like, Kaluga, you are Yuma's familiar. You cannot be on the participate in a task if Yuma summons you. So Robin will take your place as in one of your students as one of the teachers by default. What? No! No, like I can totally imagine there'd be like a joke with their in fact I could even see like the last it would be hilarious if in the next chapter, if Lead gets defeated, eliminated first, or how this is gonna go, if Kaluga responds to the gods as like with a long complaint about Robin, but like, you could have ended this in the first second if you simply went to both of the balloons. There was nothing stopping you. They weren't even aware. Your incompetence is beyond belief. You are suck. I mean, I would love it if there's something like that happened. But yeah, anyways. Now, what could happen in the next? I'm guessing, no, I'm not like 100% sure, but I feel like the ones we saw in this chapter are gonna be like the ones we get the most amount of development from. Like, the ones we'll be focusing the most, like Team Yuma, Team Asmodeus, Team Valak, Team Sabnak, Team Cosell, Team Agaris, Team Agres, Team Kamoy. I'm guessing that's what we're gonna get, like, the most focus. With team, like, Team Jazz, Team Gap, Team Elizabeth, being, like, the ones who, Team Person, with those guys, like, not really getting, like, maybe just us finding out, oh, did they win, did they lose? I'm guessing that's where we are going with this. I don't know, it's like, they don't mention it, but I could be wrong about it. So, yeah. From what we've seen, I'm definitely intrigued, and I definitely want to find out the most. I'm guessing that the ones who have had, like, the least, like, interesting designs are probably gonna be the ones we get over quickly. Like, do they win or do they lose? It doesn't really matter. But yeah, I guess we'll see where this is going. Right now, I'm a bit excited. I'm definitely wondering if Lee is gonna be, like, in the first couple of seconds defeated. Like, I mean, granted, I do actually see Lee, like, defeating Robin, because, not in actual battle, I just do see him succeeding, since, you know, Robin's, like, an archer, and I'm assuming if you take away the archer's eyes and ears, then Robin would be kind of useless, and although he comes from a family that's supposed to be, like, extremely good at archery, so that may not matter to him much, but we'll see. So, anyways, this is my reaction to the Welcome to Demon School Yuma-kun. I hope you like it. I hope you leave a like, subscribe to the channel for more videos in the future. Leave a comment down below what you think of this chapter. And with that said, I cannot wait to see all of you mortals next time. Goodbye.